following program is from NET, the Public Television Network.
Just in time for the world's championship of card throwing. Josh against Christopher. It's a very tight game. Now, listen.
I won. So Josh,
you know that sound?
Alabama.
It's a siren.
No, I don't think it
could be on an ambulance or a fire engine or a police car.
No, it's not Alabama.
What's not Alabama?
Dude, the tape.
Go back and shoot another one. Another one, real quick. Now there's another sound.
I think I'll
know what it is?
Sugar. I won.
That's right. It's a jet plane. You heard that one. Jet plane overhead. How you guys doing? That's out of bounds. There's another sound. Car horn. Lots of car horns. Probably a traffic jam, right? They're all honking at each other. You know, the city has a lot of sounds, and so has the country, and the mountains, and the seashore. They have different sounds. Everywhere you listen, they're groovy sounds, if you want to listen for them. Now, my old friend Kermit the Frog has a thought or two on the subject of listening. Let's listen to him.
Hello there. My name is Kermit the Frog, and today I'm here to talk to you about groovy things that you can hear with your ears.
The Frog!
And you, I suppose, are planning to louse me up, huh?
Oh.
Listen, are you going to behave yourself?
Sure, Frog.
Okay.
Okay.
Now.
Now. Oh, go ahead.
Okay.
Okay.
Now, today we're going to talk about sounds.
What?
Sounds.
Oh.
Right. Okay, sounds.
Yeah.
Now, that's why I brought my radio along here.
Oh. See?
And now, first of all, I'm going to turn my radio on very softly. Hear that music?
Yeah.
Isn't that nice? That music is playing very softly, you know? You can hear it, but you wouldn't bother anyone in the next room, you know? On the other hand, you can play a radio very loudly. Now, watch this.
Yeah!
See, that's loud. Now, this radio is very loud, and it's not such a good idea to play a radio loud because you might bother someone, you know? And therefore, we turn the radio down, like that. Now, that's the difference between soft and loud. Soft is nice and quiet, like this, and,
Yeah! Go, Frog!
Loud is when it hurts the ears, like that. So we turn it down. Now then, we can talk about the... Hey, you! You shouldn't play the radio that loud, you might wake somebody up!
I can't hear ya!
I said you might wake somebody up!
What? Said you might wake somebody up.
But that ends my lecture for today.
Now, you know, Y is a handy letter. It's the first letter in words like yo-yo, yippee, yarn, young, yawn, year, and yellow submarine. Okay, sports fans, we're here in the Sesame Bowl, and we've got Jumpin' Josh and Crafty Chris, and they're involved in their card-throwing game, right? Now, this is a near-far game. I'll show you what I mean. Go ahead, Josh. Yours first. Wow, good one. Okay, Chris, go ahead. Nice. Now, hold tight. Let me show you what's happening here. Chris's card is nearer to the wall than Josh's card is. His card is farther away. So that means you're the winner, right, Chris?
Yes.
Okay, come on, pick him up. Bring him over here. Get your trophy a little later on. Okay, now, let's count them and see. What do I mean about a trophy? Oh, it's a great giant trophy, 20 feet tall for the champion. Okay, you want to count these for me?
No,
see how many
you get?
One,
get
two, three, four, five, six, 7, 8, 9, 10.
This is the sort of work women often do, cooking and cleaning the home and sewing. And if the women have children, well, as you know, they spend a lot of time taking care of their children. All mothers do, even this one. Then when the work is done, the kids come home from school, father comes home from work, and the whole family can relax and have fun together. That's how some families live. Sometimes, though, the mother has to work too, just like the father, and then everyone in the family has to pitch in and help out with a lot of the work.
Shall we play the game? Oh, hey, you're just in time to join Christopher and Cheryl and Bryn and myself in a little game. We were talking about things that are far, far away, like the sun and the moon and the stars and all those things, and things that are near, like our shoes and our knees and the sidewalk. Now, I've got some questions. See if you can get them with us. Now, which is farther from your nose, your elbows or your toes?
Your toes.
Toes. Your toes are definitely farther from your nose than your elbows, right? Good. Here's another one. Which is farther from your eye? The ground? Oh, here's the ground, right? Or the sky?
The sky.
Sky is farther away, right? Good. Let's see if I can think of another one. Which is farther from your knee? The ocean or me?
Your ocean.
The ocean is much farther away than my knee, right? Because that's far, far away from Sesame Street. One more. Which is farther from your head? Sesame Street or your bed?
Sesame Street.
No, not right now. Your bed is farther away because we're right on Sesame Street. So Sesame Street is very near your head now. Usually your head is near the bed, right?
Right.
Good. Let's turn them around now. Now we know all about things that are far, far away, right? Now what's the opposite of far?
Near.
Near. Right, Chris. Okay. Which is nearer to my lips? My big toes or my hips?
Your hips.
Right? Do you agree? Right. Okay. Which is nearer to my hair? The street sign over there or your chair?
My chair.
Your chair is much closer, right? Because the street sign is way, way over there. Hey, do you hear something?
Yeah.
I think it's that skywriter again. Anybody see him? Where is he today? Hey, there he is.
I see him.
I wonder what he's writing for us today.
It looks like
he's very good at writing all the letters, you know. It might be an E, or it could be an I, or what else? It's certainly not anything curved like an O. It doesn't have any curvy lines or a C. It's an L. Hey, that's a big L, isn't it? Did you know that, speaking about things far away, did you know that airplane was almost 2 miles high when he wrote that? He was. Because, hey, I hear that skywriter again. Does anybody see him?
I do. He's over
there. Where? Yeah, there he is. He's writing something else for us.
What is
it? I don't know.
An I?
Could be an I. Oh, it's getting a nice curve line along the bottom. It's not an X or anything like that, is it? Because it's
no.
Got a curve line on it. It could be a U.
Yeah, just might be.
Hey, it is a U.
U.
Hey, you know, that's two letters in 2 minutes for that skywriter. He's really going crazy today. He hardly ever writes two letters in the same day. Do you know that?
No.
If he writes all the letters, what is that called?
The alphabet.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Is that what all the letters are called?
Yeah.
The alphabet, right?
All together they're called alphabet.
Right.
Hi, Brent and I are in the midst of a game. What happened before this scene? And we have here a hat on a monkey, and this woman running, this man from the zoo running, and this door opened. Now, Brent, can you tell me what happened right before this scene?
Well, before that scene, the lady had the hat.
Yes.
And the door was locked.
Uh-huh.
And then the monkey got the key, I guess, and unlocked the lock.
Uh-huh.
And got the hat.
Yeah, right, right. And it's possible also the door was jarred open too, huh?
Yeah.
And she went after this man from the zoo to help her, huh?
Yeah.
And get, so you had to get the hat and then get the monkey back into the cage,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Okay. Here's the next one. Here we have a horse going down the street. We have the policeman chasing after it. And we have this man who, I think he is a horse rider. Now, what happened right before this?
Well, I think the horse rider was on the horse, and he got kicked off.
Who kicked him off?
The horse.
I see.
And then he started galloping down the street, and then he got a policeman. The policeman and the rider are now running after him.
Right, right. A horse loose by itself can be dangerous, can it?
Yes.
Huh? Right. All right, we're on the next one. We have a cat sitting on top of a couch. We have a lot of paper here that's strewn about. We have this young girl come in, putting up a hand. Now, what happened just before that?
I think there were a pile of newspapers, and then the cat jumped on it, and then made them scatter all around. Then when the girl came home, I guess she was at school or somewhere, she saw that there were newspapers all on the floor, and cat looks so innocent.
I like that. I think you're right, 100% right. That's an innocent cat trying to be innocent, huh? Like it didn't do anything. They know, don't they? All right, next one. Well, here's a barn, big barn in the back, in a silo, and a wooden fence. Here's a deep hole in the earth, and there are flowers, and that's a pig. Now what went on right before that?
Well, the flowers, he wasn't stepping on the flowers.
He wasn't?
And he didn't pull one down.
Well, what was he doing?
He's tearing the flowers off the ground.
Oh, how'd he get there?
He might have been born there, or he might have been bought.
Born or bought? What's this big hole here about?
I think it's a mud hole.
A mud hole?
Yeah, for...
Well, why the fence and the barn and the silo?
Well, the silo's to keep the hay.
Yes.
And the barn's to keep some other animals.
Yes. So maybe the pig was there with the other animals.
Yeah.
And it came in the area where the garden is.
Yeah.
And through the hole, right?
Right.
All right. Okay.
I'm making a scarf for Gordon. It's going to be one of those real long, long ones, you know, that you wrap around a lot. And it's going to be really good and warm. I'm not very far, though. This is just the beginning. Gee, you know, everything has a beginning. It grows into something big from the beginning. Well, I'm not doing so good, but I'll keep trying. Well, it's time to say goodbye again today. I don't know where the time goes, but you're gonna come back and see us again here on Sesame Street, aren't you? Good, because we're always here. You know where to find us. All right, bye now.
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters L, U, and Y, and by the numbers 4 and 5. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.
This is NET, the Public Television Network.